Before our Lagos report, joining me live from Abuja via Zoom is the Chairman, House Committee on Basic Education, Julius Inyobere. Thank you for joining us on TVC News at 10. Well, the coronavirus pandemic is here, the second wave some have described, tsunami. In what way is the House coming in to ensure the nation is able to contain the spread of the virus, especially with students now back in schools?
Thank you. Thank you very much. First, in the budgeting process, the House ensured that we gave additional support to the relevant ministries, health, education, security, in order to put into consideration preparation for the COVID and the necessary responses. But in the consultation process leading to the announcement of January 18th, we were not carried along. Be that as it may, the members of the Committee on Basic Education reviewed the data before us, consulted with our constituencies, and came to the conclusion that we were not truly prepared. Maybe in the capital cities, in the federal government unity schools, in the government-owned secondary schools, and some of the elite private schools, yes. But in the majority of primary and secondary schools in this country, not even 5% of the necessary processes, compliance with COVID-19 protocols have been put in place. And we expressed our worry. We understand that schools need to resume. We have to live with COVID for a while. We understand the pains of staying at home for a long time, but it's better to stay at home and go into a safe environment than go into one that will lead to contamination and death.
Our Honorable Inyobere,
the argument that,
if I may come in very quickly, you chair the Committee on Basic Education. So what suggestion are you giving to the executive arm of government? Is it that schools should be closed at this time, those who have already resumed should return home, or what exactly are you suggesting?
Well, if we had to do that to make sure that our children are safe and we do not add to the already quadrupled spike in COVID, there is nothing wrong with it. In the majority of schools, in 90% of the schools in this country, there is no running water. Arrangements have not been made for social distancing. Teachers have not been trained on how to handle COVID emergencies. They have not prepared the database of the status of its instructors' health situation so that we know which teachers have taken the COVID test and are free. They have not provided sanitizers, temperature checks, and other requirements. The federal government itself prepared what it called a school readiness template. These are not being followed by many states. So all we are saying is that please, as we want to resume, have we put these things in place? Let the federal government invite some relevant NGOs and stakeholders and carry out a nationwide inspection so we can identify where the shortfalls are and take adequate responses. That's all we are saying.
All right, Honorable, and this might just be time to take more seriously the initiative which was embraced during the first, during the first phase of the pandemic, which was e-learning. Let's see how much that will be embraced and what difference, what change it should actually bring to the table. Chairman, House Committee on Basic Education, Julius Inyobere, thank you for joining us on TVC News at 10.